This is the Postage Miser, made in the 1990s. And another similar thing, made, I don't know, a couple years ago. Has a little grabby clip, a ring over here that you use to hold it up with, and a scale with markings with a little pointer. You clip the clip onto something, you hold it up like this, and the pointer over here tells you how much it weighs. The Postage Miser is made by the Metal Products Engineering Corporation in California, and they're still making it today. You can buy a new one right now at their website. It's a way to be sure. Apparently, it used to be called the Personal Post Office, but I guess the United States Postal Service made them change the name. This one was given to me by my friend Irene. Thanks, Irene. She still had the original vinyl pouch and the original postage rates card. The card says the rates are accurate as of July 1995, so I'm guessing this was made around then. And this other one I just bought on Amazon last week. This is modern technology here. And I've taken the opportunity to shoot my first ever unboxing footage. Just imagine. It's like opening a package yourself, but instead of you doing it, I'm doing it. And I get to keep what's inside, and you get nothing. This one doesn't really have a brand name. On Amazon, it's just called Postal Scale, Small and Portable Weight Detection Device. Weight Detection Device. All right. The Postage Miser is a bit older than this other one, but it wasn't the first, not by a long shot. Here's another one made by a German company that you can buy right now. These things go way back. This one was made in Brussels in the early 20th century, and it's got almost the same design as my Chinese one. Here's one made in French in the 1800s. I found another one that's on eBay right now. These are all examples of what's called a pendulum scale. There's some kind of pointer which swings back and forth like a pendulum according to how heavy the thing is. This great graphic comes from the International Society of Antique Scale Collectors, the ISASC. The pendulum scale is an innovation on the very old steelyard balance, which has a sliding counterweight. On the steelyard, you delicately position the counterweight until it balances, and then the position of the counterweight will give you your reading. A pendulum scale is, in theory, a bit faster and easier to use. You don't have to play around with the counterweight or do anything, really. You just dangle the thing and read the answer. These two devices are obviously the same basic idea, but the designs are pretty different. This one seems to be going for a kind of Art Deco steampunk feel, very angular and kind of retro styled, and it very clearly looks and feels like a pendulum. It's really just a rigid pendulum with one extra hinge in the middle, and the pointer is just measuring the movement in the hinge. When it sits straight, it points to zero. And when it leans to the side, it points to something else. The Postage Miser is all about curves. It's almost futuristic. There's no hard angles at all. And the basic hinged pendulum mechanism is kind of hidden. On this thing, the top part of the pendulum, if you want to call it that, is here. And the lower part is just this little swinging guy. You can read grams on this side, and if you turn it around, you can read it in ounces. This little hanging indicator on the Postage Miser is pretty touchy. Usually it'll jump around a lot just from small movements in your hand. I had to rest my elbow on the table just to get it to be this still. The other one works the same way, but the indicator is this solid pointer, so it's a little less sensitive to little movements. So, how accurate is it? Oh, look, it's Dengar! Hang in there, buddy! Dengar's looking between 15 and 20 grams. I'm going to go with, I don't know, 17, 18 grams. The other one's scale is a little nicer. I'm going to say 18 grams. My digital kitchen scale puts Dengar at 20 grams, so that's pretty good, I guess. It's hard not to like these things. Small and cheap, unlikely to break, and totally transparent to the user. There's no confusing mechanism. This is not much of a mechanism at all. It just dangles. We know how that feels. I appreciate the curves of the Postage Miser, and I appreciate the angles of this other one. A little something for everybody. They're both around the same size, but this one can fold up to be smaller. The upper arm is actually a band, so the thing can swing all the way down here. That's a nice touch. To me, this one's the more accurate, easier to use, but would you forgive me if I still prefer the Postage Miser? Here's a fun fact. The Steelyard scale is very old. Here's one they excavated from the city of Pompeii. There's documentation of this basic design being used around 500 BC. And this is several centuries before the basic mathematics of the lever was developed by Archimedes. Yet another time in our history when the engineers were ahead of the mathematicians. The people who built these instruments originally, they didn't fully understand them mathematically, but they built them anyway. To build such a mechanism without even understanding the mathematics, that's a real achievement. And where does this put Archimedes? Many of his so-called discoveries were already in use by the craftspeople of his day. So what did he even do? Well, I'd say his real achievement was asking hyper-detailed questions about everything, even things that everybody thought they already understood. Some guy who uses a Steelyard scale every day will probably tell you that he knows all there is to know about balancing levers. But it takes a real scientist, a real mathematician, to look at something ordinary and dare to imagine that our knowledge is incomplete. In mathematics, it's usually not the answers that move us forward, but the questions. Like, here's a question. What if I clip this one on here, but then clip this one on here? No. Even I know not to play God.